It was close to 20 years without even being diagnosed, first of all. You were concerned, right? What is he going to be able or not able to do? That's scary.
Having CF in the 90s, you know, the life expectancy estimations were still in the late 20s.
When the dust settled, in a sense, it became obvious that I had a left leg paralysis as a result of the polio.
It flashed in front of my face, you know, walking down the aisle with my dad and maybe never being able to do that, you know.
We went to four different surgeons who said, we're not going to do surgery because his liver won't tolerate it. And of course, scientifically, I knew what that meant, but emotionally, I wanted personalized medicine, right? I wanted what we had been working on, what I had been working on for 10 years at the time.
I still remember this conversation as it was yesterday when we were together in her car, and she said, crying, she said, I had this situation, I need to have surgery, I just want to know, are you with me or not? I can't count, you know, as milliseconds that I say, of course I am, of course, we are together in this. It's not only the person that has the disease, it's not only the patient, the whole family, their friends, that has a clear impact in this situation. When I started working here, I started to connect with this. How can I improve people's lives in this situation?
You know, I wanted to be a part of the innovation, wanted to be a part of the patient experience. That my purpose for being here isn't cash, it's not prestige, but really, you know, motivated by that impact.
My feeling was, if you want to study medicine, you study medicine. You work in a hospital, you help people. If you want to be a scientist, you work in a lab and you play with things and you make discoveries. The real eye-opener was being here and then realizing that these two, in a sense, are completely joined.
As soon as I got in, I thought, no, I'm actually an advocate for the patients now, because I know that when I see a healthcare professional or if I'm training a specialist, I know that we're training them to help the doctor understand what our medications are all about and what difference it can make for their patients.
There are some days that it's really emotional for me. I know what it means to have to tell patients that there are side effects, right? Or to tell patients that we're just not ready yet and that medication's not ready yet.
A lot of people, even in my family, they say, this is something that you really want to do because it's not only you and her, it's maybe the kids that you will have in the future, that maybe you will be alone with these kids. And I say, honestly, I don't care. This is the life that I want to have. Even if it's very short, the time that I spend with her, I want to be with her. And today has been 19 years together.
Liz Navarro, Product Training Manager.
My name's Eli Goldberg. I'm a data scientist and engineer.
My name is Claire Thomas, and I'm a sample manager for PCS in Cambridge.
Chinwike Okomedo, Director, Translational Medicine.
My name is Renee Bergeron, and I'm the Preclinical Safety Therapeutic Area Head for the Respiratory Portfolio.
I am Juan Luis Fuentes. I'm the Integrity and Compliance Head for Novartis Oncology for Latin America and Canada.